The ICEVI, the Nippon Foundation Mathematics Package for Teachers. Title of the video, An Identity in Set Language. What do we mean by that? Let us consider two sets A and B, and these are expected to be overlapping. Overlapping means they have something in common. Now let us take two sets A with four elements 1, 2, 3, 5 and set B with four elements 2, 3, 6, 8 as these letters and also the numbers have braille markings, so it will help the visually impaired child to identify clearly. Now, the identity in set language says when these sets are overlapping, the cardinal number of the A union B is nothing but the number of elements of set A plus the number of elements of set B minus the number of elements of A intersection B. Now, we know n of A, that is number of elements in set A, it is 4. Number of elements in set B, it is 4. So, we have the two known values. Now, we have to find out the number of elements in A intersection B. What is A intersection B? A intersection B is nothing but the objects which are common between A and B. So, A intersection B equals 1 in set A. Is it found in set B? No. That means 1 cannot be part of the intersection. Then take 2 from set A. Is 2 found in set B? Yes, 2 is found in set B. So that means 2 becomes a part of A intersection B. Now what about 3? 3 is found in both sets A and B. So 3 becomes a part of the intersection. Then what about 5 in set A? It is not found in set B, and similarly 6 and 8 in set B, they are not found in set A. So between the set A and set B, there are two common elements, that is 2 and 3. So what is n of A intersection B? That is 2. We have to find out how many elements are there in the A union B now. What is A union B? A union B is nothing but the distinct categories. Now, 1, 2, 3, 5. So these will become 1, 2, 3, 5. Will become part of the A union B. Now, you find out from the set B, is 2 there? Yes, 2 is already included. So, you cannot include that number because it will be a repetition. 3 is included? Yes, 3 is included. So, it will be a repetition. Now, what about the other numbers? There are two numbers, 6 and 8. 6 and 8 are not part of the intersection, so 6 and 8 are the part of the union here. 6 and 8 are part of the union. So in the A union B, you have 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 8. Then what is the number of elements in A union B? That is 6. Now we have the number of elements in each set. In A, it is 4. In B, it is 4. In A intersection B, let the child count, it is 2. In A union B, it is 6. Now apply the formula. In A union B, number of elements in A union B, we have 6. So that is 6. And what is that? Number of elements in set A, that is 4. Now what is the number of elements in set B, that is 4. So what will happen? 4 plus 4, that will become 8. What is the number of elements in the intersection? It is only 2. So minus 2. So what happens? It is 8 minus 2, that is 6. That means the identity in set language is proved that the number of elements in A union B equals number of elements in A plus number of elements in B minus number of elements in A intersection B. Now, in the case of non-overlapping sets, if A and B are not overlapping, that means no, there is no intersection, then the N A union B will be simply number of elements in A plus number of elements in B. How you can prove that? Suppose you take the common elements away. You take the common elements away. That means A becomes 1, 2 and 5. B becomes 6 and 8. So there is no intersection happening between A and B. So N of A equals 3. N of B equals 2. The union is nothing but all these numbers. That is 1, 2, 5, 6, 8. So the number of elements in A union B is nothing but 5. So which is the addition of number of elements in set A and number of elements in set B.